Well, today, Secretary of State Antony Blinken faced more intense questioning from both Republicans and Democrats on the frenzied U.S. withdrawal from Afghanistan. 13 U.S. service members were killed by a suicide bomber during that evacuation. Here's CBS's Nancy Cordes.
In Indiana and Massachusetts today, services for two of the Marines killed in the suicide bombing at the Kabul airport. 3 weeks after that attack, questions about the chaotic U.S. drawdown continue to consume Washington.
There is not enough lipstick in the world to put on this pig to make it look any different than what it actually is.
Senators from both sides grilled Secretary of State Antony Blinken today about the last-minute scramble to rescue Americans and Afghans as Kabul fell.
Should we not have surged more significantly?
Bottom line is, we did significantly surge. But what was not anticipated was the collapse in 11 days of the Afghan government and the Afghan military.
I just don't think that's true.
This wasn't a failure of intelligence. This was a failure of policy and planning.
Blinken conceded that the intelligence community had warned back in June that a swift Taliban takeover was likely. But he argued the Trump administration tied the Biden team's hands, leaving behind a withdrawal date, but no plan.
You are the United States Secretary of State. You own this.
State Department was talking to the Defense Department to slow down the pace of military withdrawal, calling actually for, quote, tapping the brakes on military withdrawal. Isn't that true?
Senator, I'm not going to get into any internal deliberations or discussions that that we had. We worked on this together every step of the way.
Intelligence officials warned today that now that the U.S. has left Afghanistan, al-Qaeda is already starting to move back in. And their new estimate is that the terror group could reconstitute to the point where it might be able to strike the U.S. homeland in 1 to 2 years, Norah.
That's alarming. Nancy Cordes, thank you.